So in this video I will be talking on ERK pathway, which is also called classical ERK pathway or mitogen activator proteinase kinase pathway. The ERK means extracellular regulated kinase. So ERK pathway. So there are three types of mitogen activator proteinase kinase pathway, which are ERK mediated, that is extracellular regulated kinase mediated, and P38 MAP kinase mediated, and c-Jun NH2 terminal kinase, which is JNK mediated pathway. So there are three different type of kinase, and in that I will be explaining on ERK, that is extracellular regulated kinase. So the examples for ERK pathway mediated signaling include those signaling which is mediated by epidermal growth factors or platelet derived growth factors. All these show cell responses through this ERK signaling. So next is ERK signaling associated important functions include cell proliferation, differentiation, apoptosis and cell senescence. So in all these cases ERK pathway is important. So I am going to talk on the components of the canonical ERK pathway. So one of the major component is receptor tyrosine kinase, which is a receptor. These receptors get autophosphorylated upon binding to their respective ligands. Example EGF or EGF binding to the EGFR receptor. So next component is GRB2. So it's an adapter protein having two SH3 and one SH2 domain. So its SH2 domain interact with the tyrosine phosphorylated sequences, and SH3 domain interact with the protein-rich regions of other proteins. So next is SOS. This is a guanine nucleotide exchange factor. This protein forces the RAS protein to exclude GDP and take up GTP. So next component is RAS. So RAS proteins are guanine nucleotide binding proteins. So it is a GTPase which hydrolyze GTPs. So RAS is active upon binding to GTP, and the rate of GTP hydrolysis determines its activity. So binding of GTPs causes conformation changes in the RAS. And the point mutation in the RAS is very common, leading to the permanent activation of RAS. This always happens in the cancer, various cancer. So next component is RAF. RAF is a family of serine or threonine specific protein kinase. RAF denotes a rapidly accelerated fibrosarcoma. So MEK1O2 is another component of ERK pathway, and it is activated by RAS protein. So that means it is downstream to the RAF. So the RAF protein is phosphorylated at serine 218 or serine 222. So N-terminal region of MEK2 is the docking site for ERK. Next component is ERK. ERK1 and ERK2 are 85% identical and also share many functions. So ERK1 is phosphorylated by MEK8, threonine 202 and tyrosine 204. And ERK2 is phosphorylated at threonine 185 and tyrosine 187. Next component is ELK1. It's also called ETS1-like1. It's a transcription factor activated downstream to MAPK pathway. One is phosphorylated at serine 383 by ERK. So ELK1 binds to the ETS1 binding region in the DNA. Activated ELK1 associates with the serum response factors and activate transcription of the gene. Next is serum response factor. It's a transcription factor protein. SRF binds to the serum response element in the promoter region of respective gene. Serum response factor binding regions are found in the promoter of immediately early genes which are required for cell cycle. Example C4. Now I am going to explain the ERK pathway through the animation. First thing what is going to happen is you can see the different components of the ERK pathway: epidermal growth factor, RAS, GRB2, SOS, RAF, MEK, ERK and ELK1. All these I have been explained before in the PPT. So first, epidermal growth factor bind to the receptor, leading to the phosphorylation of the receptor at the cytoplasmic domain. This causes the GRB2 proteins to bind to the cytoplasmic domain of the receptor in the phosphorylated region. And the next, SOS adapter bind to the GRP on the membrane, which will be localized to the membrane, causing the RAS to exclude the GDP and accept GTP. This causes the activation of the RAS. This leads to the phosphorylation of the RAS proteins. So RAS protein will be recruited and it will get phosphorylated. So the RAS protein can now phosphorylate the MEK, leading to their phosphorylation. So now MEK will be phosphorylating ERK 1 or 2, leading to the phosphorylation of ERK. Now ERK will move into the nucleus to phosphorylate ELK1, and the phosphorylated ELK1 can bind to the ETS1 binding region in the DNA, which is close to the serum response element. So you can see SRF protein bind to that region. ELK1 will get associated with SRF to activate the transcription of the immediately early gene such as C4. So ELK1 binding to the SRF will activate the transcription.